You want to bring in, swipe in the charms or swipe down the task.
So now this comes with wallpaper that is 4K wallpaper, which is very high def. This has an app called Chromatune that comes with Chromatune. So this is the, right here, I've got it on Technicolor. This is Technicolor.
So they're changing the color space too.
Exactly. And so if you're a photographer, professional photographer, you're doing 4K video especially, this is important because you have perfect color fidelity. If you're just a high-end user, you want to click this over to Rec 709 is my favorite. You can go a setting called full and then cool and warm. I don't know why people would want cool and warm.
No, but that's terrible.
But Technicolor is accurate and Rec 709 looks best in my opinion. But you have this very easy method to switch between them. And of course, it's certified Technicolor. Again, that's really huge for people who really need, you know, professionals need color fidelity. Has HDMI. It has four 3.0 USB 3.0 ports.
One for your tablet for sure. This is for an artist. Boy, this is great.
That's right. Now, oddly enough, here are the caveats that I have about this. You'd think, well, okay, this is a super high-end. This is like the laptop that has the greatest video you can imagine. Mm-hmm. It's not really the case. When you're doing 4K stuff, it is great. When you're doing true color fidelity photography and video, it's great. For everything else, it is not that great. It's pretty mediocre. There's inconsistency in the font rendering. So some of the fonts don't look crystal clear as they do on the MacBook Pro with Retina, for example. All the fonts on the MacBook Pro with Retina look fantastic. And, you know, so let me just give you an example if I can find it here.
I wonder if this might be a Windows problem as much as it is the hardware problem.
It could be. It depends on the site. A lot of the Google sites don't look all that high res for...
I think that's, you know, Chrome, for one thing.
Right.
Yeah. We had that problem when the Retina MacBooks first came out, is Google Chrome looked terrible.
Yeah.
Apple solved this somewhat by having a high DPI solution, which means you'd run it at 1080p unless you had an image that was higher quality, and then it would jump to that.
Yeah.
I don't know if Windows has such a great, easy way to do that on Windows.
Yeah.
I run my Windows at 19... or my Mac at 1080p on a 4K display.
Yeah. Now, one of the things, you mentioned games earlier. This is one of the surprises. This is not good for high-resolution games. You have to dial down the resolution in order to get reasonable performance on the
surprised.
Game. So you can't play games at 4K.
What's the GPU? It's a Radeon?
It's a Radeon. Yes, it's a Radeon GPU. It has 2 gigs of video RAM. It's a Radeon R9 M265X.
Okay.
The GPU is fine. The problem is that the games haven't been written for 4K.
Right.
And again, 4K content is a problem. You can find some 4K content on YouTube, but really it's in the minority. Netflix has some 4K content. But really, if your expectation is that you're going to get this laptop and you're going to be watching 4K content all the time, you're not.
Well, and the other thing is you take a hit with 4K because it's going to hit the CPU. It's a lot of work to push those pixels.
Yes, it is.
And it's going to kill the battery life.
Well, one of the weird things about this, it's got a fan on this on the right side. So if you're using a mouse, an external
you
mouse,
feel it. In,
it's like, yeah, it's like a blow dryer pointed at your hand.
Well, it's good for sweaty palms.
It's great when it's cold. It'll keep your hand warm, at least one of
Is it a loud fan, too?
It's You can hear it.
Yeah.
Yeah. When it gets going, it's not so bad right now. But once you start pushing 4K around, it gets kind of loud. You know, again, so let me just get to the recommendation because this is where the rubber meets the road. If you're a professional and you have some use for 4K, this is a great product because it's a laptop. It's Technicolor certified. It's relatively inexpensive, $1,799.
Oh, that's not bad.
Yeah, if you look at what the Mac Pro is, for example, that's another 4K option for professionals, not a portable. That is really, you know, this is a
It's $2,500.
Computer, yeah.
Same specs.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Well, without the monitor.
Right.
Right. So, this is
The Mac Pro. Yeah, that's $3,000.
Right. Right.
But a Mac Pro with Retina display, 15-inch, is about $2,500. So, $800 more.
Yeah. Exactly. It's good for that, and for certain types of professional photographers, I would say I would recommend it.
Something
but if you are a regular user who just wants a great screen, this is not the product for you. You're not going to find the content. You're not going to be able to play games and do all the things you think you're going to be able to do in 4K. You're going to be using a regular laptop that has a loud hot fan. And so I don't recommend it for ordinary users, but for professionals, I do recommend it. So this would be a buy for professionals. Don't buy for even advanced or enthusiast users.
And you know who you are. And it's a good cautionary tale. Don't buy 4K because it's not that much as 4K.
That's right.
And it really, there are penalties for running such a high resolution.
And we want people to make 4K. So if you're making 4K, get this laptop so you can see the 4K you've made.
Right.
But
right.
But if you just want to consume 4K, forget it. It's not worth it.
Mike Elgin, he's the news director at the Twit Brick House. He's also the